Hello, welcome to the Dragget Show. That's Dragget and Fair together. I am Zan, and this is Alkali.
I'm not here.
And we are here at Anthrocon Line 2021. Woo! You can find us online on YouTube under Dragget Show or on Twitch under Alkali and Zanny. With that out of the way, here's our introductions. We are here with QM.
Woo!
Boozy Badger.
Woo!
Alkali, just Bismuth, that's it, Alkali, I forget sometimes. Robbie Sinclair.
Woo!
Guest of honor, Sue the Deer.
Woo!
And Pepper Coyote.
Hello.
He whooped himself.
That was to my people, that was for the other coyotes.
Okay.
That was a howl of respect.
Oh, that was the respectful howl.
The coyote respect howl. Yes. Known famously around the world.
As respect for coyotes. You know, we have coyotes near our house. We have graveyard coyotes.
We do.
Possibly one of the upper tier of coyotes.
What the hell is a graveyard coyote?
A graveyard coyote is a coyote that hangs out in the graveyard by our house. And when we walk the streets at night smoking weed, it goes, "Can I have some?" And we say, "Yes." And then it sits there as we approach. It goes, "Wait, really? Really?" And we start getting closer and closer. And then the thing bolts and it doesn't know. I would have totally given it weed.
Oh, well, they know you.
And I know coyotes.
They read your tweets.
They totally read my tweets.
And then they read Pepper's tweets and they get mad.
That's more than the business they call a have-a-heart trap.
Anyway.
Oh, that was a have-a-toke trap.
Have-a-toke trap, yes.
I want to give a huge thank you to Robbie Sinclair,
who
showed
pretty.
Up on the Dragget Show for the first time. I used to watch Dinosaur.
Not the first time. Robbie has been on several times.
Was I drunk?
Yes. And how?
So it doesn't count.
Hi, this is my first time on the Dragget Show.
Yay. This is the first time on the ground on the Dragget Show.
Second time there. That I remember.
I mean, what?
I watched Dinosaurs. Did all of you watch Dinosaurs?
Absolutely.
I didn't know what it was because I was six, but yes.
You were the prime market.
I feel like I just drank from the wrong grail.
I didn't know what subtext was. I was trying to learn what the letter M was.
M stands for massacre when it comes to dinosaurs. That's how that show worked.
Actually, no, that was the finale.
It was amazing.
That
was one of the...
Quick, buy the rights to his oil.
Like, it was like, here's your funny puppet show, and now they all die.
You want to know how ahead of its time Dinosaurs was? It's like, yeah, by the way, you're all going to die by climate change. Bye. Thanks, Disney.
Well, no, you know how Alf ended? Alf ended with Alf getting captured by the government, and then it cut the plot.
Yep.
What?
They planned to end on a cliffhanger. They got canceled after it aired. They ended up, like, several years later doing a made-for-TV movie to reassure children that Alf didn't get dissected in New Mexico.
And then the Dragget Show remade that to a dissection in New Mexico.
Louis, get me out of here.
I didn't know E.T. and Alf was the crossover I needed.
Let's get off of alien torture, I guess.
Yeah, let's get off of alien torture. We were on dinosaur torture. Oh. So, the end of dinosaurs. Who actually saw, like, when it was airing? So most of us, except for Pepper...
I saw it like 10 years later.
All right, so let's go over Pepper. Pepper, in your formative years, what kind of shows were you watching? Like, what were you watching on TV, if at all?
This sounds so freaking weird because I know what current kids watch. And current kids watch SpongeBob. And I was watching SpongeBob seasons 1, 2, 3, and 4 as they came out. And I had the VHS. I was in the weird generation of, like, I'm a moderate to elder millennial. So I know what and grew up on cassettes, but also had, like, Kazaa.
Yeah.
And, like, we also had smartphones before I was 18, but we couldn't afford them. So, like,
from cassette to Kazaa, here comes Pepper Coyote.
I was born without the web, but now I live within it. I'm the last people to do that.
That is
You were born
deep.
Molded
like
in it.
Deep in shit, but that is deep.
You're like the bane of the internet.
Wow.
I can live in both worlds. I am the avatar. Exactly.
I mean, you do have long limbs. You
Pepper,
could straddle.
Pepper looks like Kami Joker. Let's get real.
Commie Joker.
I want you to dance down the steps so bad.
It's going to be great.
Yeah.
And if it doesn't happen, cut that out. Get it.
You do look very good, though. You've been working out, man. You've been saying you did, too, right?
I'm just imagining, Pepper. You want to know how I got these scars? The working class, does it?
Oh, no.
I'm blind.
The ruling class are the scars on humanity. All right.
All
right. I was blind.
Now you can see.
I can see now.
He has special eyes.
I like watching Robbie move this 45-pound Anthrocon sign. I don't know if you can see it, but this is an actual, like, hand-welded by a person who was present hunk of metal in honor of Pittsburgh. Is it steel? Because that'd be ironic. Well, not ironic. Fitting.
Hey, Brian Cage.
Yeah, appropriate. Yeah.
Are you just doing curls down there?
He is, yeah.
Guy is strong.
He's curling the con.
By the way, this is... This is wonderful to do. Thank you for letting us do this, of course.
Yes.
It is a little weird, though. Let's address the elephant in the room. It's freaking weird because we're usually doing this.
Stop calling me the elephant in the room. I have asked you so many times.
That is
the long elephant in the room.
He's not even pink. Come on.
No.
I mean, woozle.
Paint.
Just the elephant. Okay. Anyway, the elephant in the room of just like. We usually have an audience for this, so, like, it's weird just, like, something happens, and like, I hope that went well in chat. F in chat for laugh, please.
Has the chat gone pog over our last joke?
Right.
Oh, God.
Is Harambe coming back? All right. Yeah. What are the kids like? Harambe?
Too soon. Too soon.
Too soon.
Too soon.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry, Chicago. Shout out to my homies. All right. Shout out to my Harambes and...
And then Dragger is dooming with Dragger. There's a running joke where you press F to rar. So F to rar is
F.
It, yeah, F ignites your special ability, and you F to rar if you're the lizard. So it works out that way.
Hold on. To use our special abilities, all we have to do is push F. QM, what is your special ability that you're going to push F to use? It can be anything. It can help out at a convention. It could help out in the bedroom. It could help out in the bedroom at a convention.
Wait a second.
Don't make me push F to R. I'm blind.
That's mine.
If I had the ability to disappear for like any length of time just to like get my bearings and then poof back, I would do it in a freaking heartbeat.
Okay, I can help you with half of that.
I'm pretty sure that's called a kidnapping.
I can certainly help you with the disappearing part.
No.
The coming back, something different, though.
No.
There you go.
This is on camera, and I just threatened my spouse.
Wouldn't be Anthrocon without
it. Aren't they so cute? He just threatened to hide her body.
And you know you're going to be the first suspect, right?
No.
I think that man's baiting that poor little girl.
Jesus Christ.
And that is just the weirdest thing I've ever said that's got a laugh. I feel terrible.
I put it in top 10. I've known you for a while now. Top 10.
And it is fun because we can't block off traffic. So we do have, we have comers through. So if that happens, it happens.
That is always fun.
Uh-huh. Comers through. What?
That's the name of the new bathhouse. All right. Pepper, push F to R. What's your superpower? Oh, Pepper doesn't know if he wants a musical superpower or a superpower.
I, as a fool, assumed that it wasn't going to come around to me, this prompt.
You're a fool.
So I put literally zero thought into it.
Ah, improv.
I thought you
understood.
Were safe, but it said, they're over here.
Hey, you hate trying? Try improv.
I would press F to... This comes from the fact that all we've been doing during quarantine is streaming. Is press F to be able to just, like, get through a fucking video game section that I know how to do. I just need to execute. Like, within the first three times. That's
press
all I
F
want.
To fuck this part and
just
move on.
Just get through. Like, I get what I'm supposed to do. Fly through the rings. Okay. Time limit. And just get moving on. That's all I want.
That is actually a thing I've heard is a thing in more games. Where, like, you know, we're adults. You don't have to play this part. Just go to the next part.
If they just give it to me as a freebie, that feels like cheating. But if I somehow have a superpower, I guess that wouldn't be cheating.
That is fair.
It's your natural ability. It's not your fault.
I would at least be able to do it.
It is always a good sign when there's like five cameramen around the camera, all of them going,
Can we? Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Okay, we're supposed to not mention that. The cameramen are having a meeting.
They're having a small orgy behind
that
the lens.
Okay, that is not how it works. It's a flock of birds. It's not an orgy of cameramen.
They're all going. Is that actually Bruce Willis and he wandered onto our set, or do we see dead people?
If someone doesn't address the threateningly spinning cylinder in the room, I may be disquieted for the rest of the evening.
Yeah, what is that?
There appears to be a device that is about a Bush's baked bean family-sized can of whatever spinning at high speeds. What could that possibly... I've been thinking, is it a surveying tool?
Oh my god, are you making paint? Is that a paint
shape? That is a paint. See, there are certain furries who enjoy certain things, and I'm going to trail off at this moment.
Is that how they write heart?
Is that is a pencil sharpener.
Is that how they record heart?
Electric pencil sharpener. Yeah, stick your finger in there. Stick your finger in there.
Do not stick your finger in there!
Oh my god.
Is it not hard disk drive? It's hard cylinder wheel?
All right. Allow me to give you a lesson,
Robbie,
from my
here.
Days growing up in grade school. The pencil sharpener can sharpen many things. Salami is not one of them. Just putting it out there.
So that's what we're calling it these days.
Yeah,
that's what
we
okay.
What about summer
Robbie,
sausage?
Take my phone.
Absolutely.
You can do some.
You have a point.
Journalism.
No, summer sausage
take
wouldn't be a
you
thing in that school because you know it's
journalism with that.
Yep. Unless it's summer school.
Unless it's summer school.
Unless it's summer school.
All right, I distracted this the dinosaur.
This is related and has a point. I was talking about how I still had cassettes, even though I'm technically not even old enough for that. What was the first helicopter? There is a helicopter. Okay. What is the first physical media you remember, like either owning or buying or using, whichever is more interesting for you? Go for it. I don't even have one. So
CD, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles soundtrack.
What?
Out of their shells?
No, A Secret of the Ooze. The first
original
movie soundtrack.
I got one.
The movie.
What do you got,
I was a member of one of those, like, pay a penny and order, like, 11 cassettes
the
music
Columbia
club.
The Columbia Record
Club? From the beginning? Were thrifty?
From the beginning. Yeah. And one of my first cassettes in that first, 11 was Prince's Under the Cherry Moon.
Nice.
And
really?
I think I may have been like 9 or 10.
Damn.
We had cable.
That's so cool.
And inattentive parents. So.
Wow.
No, yeah. I did the same thing. Only like I think my first was like, goddamn, it was like the early 90s. So there was like some Nirvana in there, Alice in Chains, Pearl Jam.
First one I bought myself was System of a Down, so we were like very close in the same record like section.
I had System, hell yeah.
I bought Hypnotize, Mesmerize, the first thing I bought with my own money, first CD.
Really?
Yeah,
holy crap, good
absolutely.
First purchase. Jeez. Oh my, I had bad taste
Why
growing
don't
up.
Presidents fight the war? Why do we always send the poor?
Awesome.
And here I am buying MC question. Hammer when I'm a kid.
The music gets better every year.
Boozy?
Oh, what?
What was your first media?
And superpower.
God, I don't fucking know.
You don't remember? Everyone remembers.
I bought this. I don't remember breakfast, motherfucker.
There's a good reason you don't remember breakfast.
I do know one of your first favorite TV shows, though, because your mom like bought you the complete collection of Elf on DVD as soon as
that's
she
amazing.
Could.
That's amazing.
If
did
that's
she? Yes. Yes, she did.
Oh.
We have the entire run of Elf because she said...
Where? I've never seen it.
Downstairs in our in our
Yo,
living room.
Boozy, what if she was lying? What if she was actually making? She's like, you have no idea. We don't actually own Elf on DVD.
I'm gonna go home and check on Sunday. No, I'm not. I'm gonna forget about. I'm gonna walk in the door, take off my pants, and fall asleep in the recliner like every other 40-year-old dad.
My parents actually had a surround sound system. I don't mean like nice speakers in the corner. I mean, my dad took some cords and ran them around the living room, and those big old 80s speakers that are like this big, but sound like they're this big, all over the room, but not hooked up to anything we would use, hooked up to a record player. Well, I went and got a record. The only one I recognized, and I was so happy, because for about a week straight, the only thing playing in that house, they're coming to take me away, ha-ha. They're coming to take me away, oh-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha, to the funny farm. And that really helped out in life. Because at a buddy's wedding that we went to, they had karaoke. And they all told me I had to do karaoke, and I do not sing. I do not sing at all. I think I did backup for one of your tricks, and you're like, no, you're doing this. I want you to repeat these four words over and over. 2 hours later, you told me, look, you're not doing great, but I'll fix it in post. And at that wedding, they had, they're coming to take me away, which since I had memorized, instead of, you know, standing at the stage, I did the next best thing. A person got up to go to the bathroom, and I had a wireless mic, so I followed her around the hotel singing all the, they're coming to take me away, ha ha, they're coming to take me away, and I just followed her, and she didn't leave the room, and I just chased her, and I got a standing ovation, except for her friends. They did not like it. Good night.
Well, you think that you could blend a standing ovation into fleeing a madman, like, pretty smoothly, like, hurrah, okay.
I mean, especially if you there, you just transition.
That'd be crazy. Where'd my bourbon go?
Oh, there it is. Thank interesting.
You. Continue, everyone.
Continue. We're just watching a very awkward act of, you know.
It's press F to R. Who hasn't
done it? Oh, yes. Who's, yeah, Boozy, what's your power?
Who hasn't done this? Their
superpowers. What's your
oh, my press F to R power?
Yeah.
I have a superpower.
You know, I think I have everything I want in life. I have a wonderful spouse and children. And if I could press F, I'd rewind about 20 years and rethink some major fucking decisions I've made.
I know my superpower now. It's wow. Better than the one
somebody
I had. It's my bullshit
detector.
Somebody wants
to sleep in their hotel room tonight.
Actually, how great would that be? Like, I hit F once, I go back in time 20 years, but I'm my age, so I just pop into that. I'm like, okay, almost there, hit F again. Pop up in my nursery, I'm a toddler. Just me and this get up, lean over the bed. Hey, you little fuck. Guess what?
Honey, you're I have two questions.
You turn
for you.
Into this!
You're assuming you're not in the crib. It's just you go back in time. You're still you, but you're you.
Yeah. The baby's gonna be like, oh my god, it looked the same just with a goatee.
Where are my cigarettes? Where?
The worst sequel to Boss Baby.
Wah! I've shit myself, and now I understand what the baby furs like about it.
And then there's this weird loop. So there's a weird loop where this messes you up for life, and that's what makes you you, right? It's you going back in time and just terrorizing yourself.
You see, this is what I love. I did that, and look at his face. He's like, we just got angry emails from half of the audience.
And the other half? Positive emails. Oh my god.
I will say to you what I said to your child. That's just you saying wah.
So this is the Dragget Show. a lot of just nonsense and us bullshitting for a whole hour, which is always fun. Hey, what's up?
Hey.
I'm trying to figure out how to phrase this, my friends.
So, inevitably, if we all live long enough, we're peeing in a diaper again. So, if you get to pick your place, first time you at least... We're not even going to be weird. First time you pee in a diaper, where do you want... Most people don't get to choose where they pee in a diaper.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
True.
If
that's
you got to pick... If you were like, you know what? I'm 99,000 years old, whatever.
Oh, my God.
Where do I want to be? Where do you want to be?
That's
you know
where
I want to be?
I want to be... You go.
I want to be... In a beautiful house.
With a beautiful wife.
In the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland. That's where I want to be. I
want to
piss myself in front of something about Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. I want to hear one of their songs and be like, oh my God! Piss. And that's what I want.
I just turned to the curator. That was my first time.
I've never heard this band. Well, no, I have a diaper, so it's just piss, and no one knows. No one, I'm dry as can be.
No,
I'm a big kid now.
If it's one of the color-changing ones, they'll know. Like, all of a sudden,
Do they have grandma's got green panties?
They will now.
Is that real?
Pepper, you just created a market.
We did.
The song that's playing when this happens is Lucky Man.
Oh, what a lucky man. Piss.
I will say.
All right, if I get to choose when I've pissed myself.
Yeah.
But if it's before the diaper, I seriously hope I'm sitting on my sister's favorite piece of furniture.
Oh, what a lucky
man. I just love how everybody's phrasing this.
If I get to choose where I piss myself, and I would like to be clear, you can always choose where you're going to piss yourself.
Yeah, well, I mean, uncontrollably. Like,
why? The only thing stopping you is your self-respect. You're a furry. Let it go and let it go.
No, it's not self-respect. It's how much the pants cost, damn it. This is an economical decision, not a shame-based one.
Please don't piss yourself on my show.
I have bourbon bug.
Did you just say, please don't piss yourself on my show? Okay,
oh, no.
How much are you going to pay me to not piss myself on your show?
Boozy.
Welcome to Boozy's show.
Boozy, you gave your best answer earlier to me when you revealed that you watched this recreationally.
He died very happy.
If you got to piss yourself voluntarily, Kentucky Derby. You're there. You're in the front row. They're across the line. You're like, oh my God. Oh my God. I'm going to win.
It is so cute that you think I have never pissed myself at the Kentucky Derby.
What is happening?
Have you ever seen the line of usual bodies in the infield? No one cares. Everyone's drunk. 9 times out of 10, there's mud. It's like peeing in a swimming pool. You piss yourself, you fall in the mud, no one notices.
My God.
Oh God. Both of you.
How's the Kentucky Derby doing on gender-neutral bathrooms?
It's a porta potty. It is the original gender-neutral bathroom.
Yes, there you go.
Outside is the original gender-neutral bathroom.
You're right.
Yo, the woods is gender-neutral as shit.
I'm really loving the fact the stage is outside because for the first time ever, I can light up a cigarette on Anthrocon stage.
We gotta give a shout out to the cancer comedians of old. You know, you get it.
you're really rocking it 90s style comedian.
That's right.
Right.
You gotta be like, insult, insult.
They're even Lucky Strikes. They start making Lucky Strikes. I'm like, oh yeah, me and the taste of grandpa's kisses. Let's go.
I don't know which microphone to be offended in.
Just be offended.
We should do
questions. I think I just involuntarily.
Yeah, when did we start?
Pepper, what did
Hold
you
on.
Do?
Say that again. Say that again. You did what? You did what?
I think I'm about to pee myself.
I just chose my...
You can choose your time.
Choose.
There are two people who are choosing this moment. This is not the moment.
I don't really believe in free choice, but that's a different conversation. But is it?
Right,
you know?
Now, there is no other place I want to pee.
Pee? There's no other place you want to pee? All
right. Right here, right now.
Got the ham.
Some people join the Dragget Show Patreons and put
Thank
in
you.
Questions that we eventually ask all the people on stage with us. But today, who the hell cares?
We're pissed.
Now, would you pee to R. Kelly just for the irony factor?
Oh my God!
And a pee
Jesus.
In the closet.
No,
he's a terrible person. Moving on.
Our first question comes from Tyro. Thank you very much, Tyro.
Yes.
Everyone, this is for the whole group. What would you replace the Pride flag with if all of a sudden the rainbow wasn't available to be on the Pride flag? I am going to expand on that question. You can also answer, what the hell happened to the rainbow?
So, Liberace.
Are Wait, you Liberace just turning ruined? Our flag into like the man? We're going to just run him up the
yeah.
flagpole?
Yeah. Why
like
not?
Wedgie-wise?
Like a rail out of town.
You know, he's not going to notice the wedgie.
He might enjoy the wedgie. That's true.
I mean, from the afterlife, maybe? I wish my brother George were here.
So we've lost the gay pride flag. Either what happened to the rainbow, or what would you replace it with?
Glitter. Well,
yes, glitter.
Glitter. You cannot get rid of glitter. Glitter gets all over everything.
We have established the flag is glitter in Gaytopia. I like this.
Yes.
I like this a lot.
Yes.
This works.
Glitter. We just want to have Gaytopia, which, by the way, is the Dragon Show gay universe. We want them to win the Olympics because at the end of our national anthem, we shoot the flag into the air and just watch the audience get angry.
Yeah. So in Gaytopia, this is how we're representing the Olympics. Everyone's mad, but it looks really good. Anyway, moving on. That's true.
What is your replacement?
Come back to me.
Understood.
Oh, dear.
Sue and Pepper, what is your replacement? Oh, no, you didn't.
I already told you,
Pepper,
yeah.
What is your replacement or what happened to the rainbow?
I don't know whether my answer should be kitschy or not. You know
yes?
what I'm saying? Like, could I be pandering and be like, replace it with the IWW flag? Like, the fucking international, the union that is the one big union, which is like, it's not really a union for anyone, but also it's a representative union of, Do I go pandery communisty?
Yes.
Or do I go like pandery the other way and be like, the Starfleet flag, blah, 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 and just motorboat? Yeah, or.
I'm sorry, there's an or? What do you got for your or?
You have to
what
say it like that,
got?
The Starfleet flag.
You know what? I say we go super weird. We go with Betsy Ross American flag. Just go, fuck it, it's gay now. You can't stop us.
Fuck it, it's
We've
gay.
Decided that the Circle 75 Betsy Ross flag, that's gay now.
We did just take the rainbow a while ago, so yeah, we can take the flag.
Oh, you like that flag? Are you gay?
Oh, that's gay now.
Also, the snake, no tread on me.
It's gay now.
It's gay now.
Totally gay now.
Gay now.
Please, Steppy.
Please, Steppy.
No Steppy Daddy.
Gay now. That's gay now.
Gay now. It's gay now. There you go. Yep.
Gay now. That's gay now. That's a flag now. It's not a rainbow. We picked this. Gay now. That's a flag now. And everyone's kind of pissed.
Oh, my God. Gay now?
All the South just left. Okay.
Most of the gays.
We're coming back to Boozy.
At me.
I think Murky from
It's on the similar note, actually.
Oh, got sorry. The flag.
Pride was a riot,
took
right?
The flag, yeah.
Fuck you, we're gay, right?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Right.
Absolutely.
What embodies that better than the Confederate flag? Can you imagine how livid the motherfuckers in Louisiana will get when you walk up to them and go, you want to hook up? Oh, I'm not gay. Then why do you have that flag on your truck, man?
Yo, dead ass. Dead ass, I have seen a rainbow Confederate flag unironically utilized in my life on this earth. Where someone's like, the South will rise again, but also dudes are hot and I want to lick that booty. Anyway, Confederate flag.
There are moments where I am convinced we live in a simulation that is slowly collapsing, and this is definitely one of them.
There are moments in my life
Pep,
where
they
somebody
a member of the
says
KKK?
Something like that, and I go, I have a perfect response, but I cannot say it on video.
Pepper.
Racism's bad, everyone. I want to say that for the tape.
Racism is bad.
Racism is bad. Everyone,
how does it feel to be the glitch in the Matrix?
It's Vuja Day. I saw that cat walk twice. By that rainbow Confederate flag.
Oh, that rainbow Confederate flag.
It didn't shift back to not being either. It could have just become a rainbow or a Confederate, but
Pepper.
Both gave me an existential crisis.
Pepper, you're wondering how there could be
you
a rainbow
a
Confederate flag. Look, we've discussed this before. That's how we know we've made progress, is when one of yours oppresses itself. That's like, yeah, we're making progress.
Fuck
oh,
yeah.
Yeah, when the gays step up to say that the gays shouldn't get married, that is a type of progress.
Yeah. I'm going to say it rhymes with Rilo, but anyway.
What?
Nothing. Look, honkies, we're talking about... Okay, never mind.
Yeah.
Hey, marriage is bad for your relationship, kids.
Hi, Sue. How you doing? You're the
I'm
guest
doing
of
good.
Honor.
How are you?
You're the guest of honor.
Never get gay married, but same-sex marriage,
so far.
Excellent.
It is true. Is this official? Are you the longest running guest of honor in Anthrocon, seeing as you've been the guest of honor for 2 years and will continue to be the guest of honor for another year?
I am the longest running domestic guest of honor because our international guest of honor also can lay claim. So there's a distinction.
Can we give you like a wrestling championship belt? You're like, I've been the reigning champion for 475
days. Oh, God,
I
hope
days.
So.
You get to hold this now.
Yeah.
No, oh, hell yeah. No. Then I'll become chairwoman or something.
We
wow.
are going that, to have.
It has to be smaller. It's WNBA.
Phrasing.
Pepper, we are going to have.
We, are you going to announce it?
Or no? No, that is
not
a secret.
Yet. There's
oh,
a
boy,
secret
teasers.
Coming. But oh boy, if you want a wrestling belt, shut up. A cricket, the coyote's natural diet staple.
Is that what fell on my head?
What?
Where is it?
The
what?
Cricket?
If you want to know what coyotes eat, it's not even Garbo. They've checked.
Garbo.
As I've read in studies. It's mostly mealworms and crickets. And if you leave your very small dog out, it'll kill it just for because it was too loud. Don't let your tiny dogs out if you live near coyotes. And guess what? If you live, you live near coyotes.
It's true.
Pepper, did you watch Snowpiercer and get hungry? I thought so. Yeah. There
when,
you go.
What
there
when
you go.
I was,
what the
a young
fuck has
boy,
happened to you over the past year?
Many things. My hair is longer.
You
I
went
been,
from kooky comedian to showing up here looking like a guy who lives in the middle of the desert in an Airstream trailer, just chowing down on peyote and screaming.
I've
about
been
the
eating
government.
Crickets.
What
That's
happened?
Why I'm so thin. It's such a protein rich. Look at me. This is the cricket diet.
The cricket
bitch,
diet.
Get on. Guess what it is? It's crickets. You eat crickets.
Bug diet.
The entire
topping.
Stop cutting your hair. Start eating the crickets.
What's your hair? Crickets make your diet.
It makes it thick.
Crickets make your hair grow thick and luscious.
It makes it crick.
Don't wait. Chirp to it.
Oh. Chirp to it? You can get some Chipotle crickets.
Chipotle crickets.
Ranch. Chipotle. Chipotle crickets.
Chipotle.
Cricket gumbo.
Cicada.
Mamma mia, that's a crickets. Spicy cricket.
Yo, real talk.
Cricket gumbo.
If tomorrow they told me the Impossible Burger was made of crickets, I'd be like, ah, so I'll eat it. I am fucked. This is protein, baby. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but protein.
The very possible burger.
The very,
please
very
eat this.
It's ants. The ants burger. It's very possible.
Now, would you?
I don't want to think of Woody Allen.
An army of protein
soon.
In everybody.
I don't
everybody.
Want the ants burger. Okay.
Would you consider eating cicadas since you know we are in an area where the cicadas have just
no, because cicadas scream.
Yeah, that's.
And I would feel bad. I would feel bad.
Those come around every once in a while, like the McRib. So, like the cicadas is the McRib. So,
every
like you know,
the cicada.
The cicada.
Look, the pure loudness makes the coyote and the cicada natural allies. We are there to produce decibels.
You they have more questions, don't you?
We do.
Absolutely.
They are the beat. We are the hook of the desert. Okay.
Our next question comes from Regda. What is the most fabulous bird species? Discuss.
Yes.
Whole group discussion.
Does it have to be real?
Ah, these are the same rules as in King's Cup, the drinking game. If you have to ask the question, first off, take a drink, and second off, just go. So there's no answer. You talk about whatever you want.
Okay, so...
But you have to take a drink.
Has everyone here has heard of Ritos, correct?
Ritos?
That's the Zelda birds?
I totally thought you said Fritos,
oh,
and I didn't
Zelda
know where
birds,
this was going.
Like from Zelda.
The birds right. from Zelda are the best birds because they pass... It's not the Bechdel test. That's when two women have a conversation,
oh
not about a man. It's the give it to me.
Jack Harkness.
The captain, they pass the Captain Jack Harkness test in that they can tell you in a language you understand that it's okay to bone down with them.
Pepper is justifying his bird lust. Let him go.
So what I'm saying is, voice actor for... I want everyone to hear this, so I gotta wait for that car to quiet down. Voice okay. actor voice actor for Revali, who thought I was bad and now thinks I am okay. Do you wanna think of... I don't wanna actually bone down with them, but I need to know that Revali is at least knows
fabulous.
Who I am and hates me in a hot way. Do you all know Revali? That's the best you can get.
Can you get a hot hate?
If he hates your hotness, you hate his hotness, and that's where it is. You hate, then you mate. That's what...
Oh, my God.
I'm learning so much today.
Shut up.
That's what they say. That's what the Ritos say, man.
Who's they?
I'm sorry.
Who's saying it?
They.
Them. Them.
He hate me. He mate. Okay.
He hate that he mate. Yes, look, makeup sex is a thing.
I cede my time. To
I seen
else.
My time.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Pepper, next time you just
We're
start
still
talking.
Trying to find that out.
Pep, next wrong. Time you just start talking, I'm just going to be like, I reclaim my time.
I reclaim my time.
It's your favorite.
Your Honor? Oh. Established gentleman from Illinois.
The most fabulous bird.
Oh, my style. Well, we got one for the Zelda bird. I'm going to go with the one that hops around with its ass out. For the mate, you know what I'm talking about.
I love it. Not only do I love the description, I just love pointing to him
the
and saying,
Sweetie
"I know
bird.
What I'm talking about."
The swingity
no,
sweetie
it's like
bird.
A whole thing. It's like, woo, woo.
Oh, the bird of paradise. That,
sure.
that one bird of paradise that has
yeah,
the blue.
Yeah,
it's really, really
that,
black. Yeah, that,
that
guy.
Total
he's fabulous.
Thing.
Yeah,
that's the one.
There's
he's
another bird of paradise that it. Well, David Attenborough learned that it is the woohoo bird, because he kept trying to say the name of the bird, and the bird would go woohoo.
Woohoo. I like that. We heard a weird crow
Define
earlier.
Fabulous.
Actually, I will leave it's that to you.
Whatever
Define
you want it to
fabulous.
Be.
If you mean fabulous as in presentation-wise, it's always the peacock.
Yes.
That is a fabulous bird.
Now, if you mean fabulous Dalton as Castle. In you know, the guy with the rainbow Confederate flag on his truck.
That's not, didn't mean that, but continue
that's
on.
That's fashbulous.
Fashbulous.
The fabulous bird is the one that you flip at him for being such a jackass.
some fabulous.
Probably the penguin.
The pink one.
The penguin.
Yeah, have you ever seen the penguin walk?
Oh, the penguin. I thought you said the pink
penguins
one.
Can't walk right. Complete bottoms.
Wow,
and they
funny.
All push one to the edge of the water and shove him in to see if the water's fine.
Now, I will argue that it is peacocks. I mean,
look,
the tails. Have you ever heard a peacock make noise? It's like,
oh yeah.
I've been married to you for over a decade. Yes, I've heard the fucking peacock.
It sounds like a human woman. And then you're out at night and you're like, where did ghosts come from? It's peacocks. Peacocks at night.
Peacocks.
Sailors take fright.
There's another noise they make. And it is woohoo!
Makes you think this thing we were made of. Make you feel brand new. Fucking New York.
Right?
Anyway.
No, actually, the other thing that they say is, oh, wow. Oh, wow. And I know this because Benny and I spent a weekend at, what's the name of it?
This is copyright stricken now.
It is like, West Safari West in California. And it just did that all night. And it was a little bit creepy when I went to change to put on PJs. And like, I take off my top and I hear, oh, wow. Like, well, at least somebody appreciates these.
Oh, wow.
See, there you go.
Oh, do you ever hear an angry peacock?
No, they all like me.
That sounds like a sex thing.
It does.
The angry peacock.
We're going to do the angry peacock.
We're going to do the angry peacock tonight. The angry peacock is when halfway through sex, you take your art project and throw it at him.
You just throw them in the paint.
I guess.
What do you got? Who's got something better than that?
The angry peacock?
It's when NBC copyright strikes you. Good, also.
So I lift up my robe and just stare at Alkali.
That's when
that's
you
my
don't
sex
get
move.
Your wished for first pee in a diaper. Angry peacock.
You become an angry peacock.
You do. You have an angry peacock.
Assuming you have a cock to pee from.
I mean...
Next goddamn question!
That's a good...
There is a bird. I believe it is pronounced hoopoo. And it has the most magnificent hidden bird mohawk of all of them, because when it's chill and or hunting, it is fully smooth dome, and when it's full hoopoo, it's like half its body height extended mohawk. It is awesome.
Nice.
Very nice.
That does sound
Look
pretty,
it up,
pretty,
kids.
That sounds
I'm trying to think of an erection joke, and I can't come up with one.
Head erection?
Thank you.
Has everyone enjoyed the mild malaise of various fauna flitting around our studio lights? Has that all caught up on the 4K display?
Nah.
4K death. 4K. There's no more.
Oh,
it
is.
Oh, the bug.
Pepper, the first bug is
Pep's
gone. I think you saw a rescue
Pep
airlift.
Wants to eat some bugs.
Oh no!
Is it not gone? I didn't drink it.
You want some protein?
It's gone.
Okay, good. I got a bug out of there 1 second before I'm like, there's no bug. If there was another bug, I
Next question.
Oh, my God. He's so drunk right now.
So coyotes drink, what was it? Crickets? That's what I said. And mealworms. Crickets and mealworms. That's what it is. What are we talking about?
Yes. Next question, Alkali.
Our next question comes from Shukin Flash. Thank you so much, Shukin. We have... What's the most creative way you've come up for or seen to beat the heat? So what do we all do? The creative way that you either have heard of or seen to beat the heat. And I'm going to have to go with your unbelievable husband. Benny gave me the greatest way to beat the heat earlier, because growing up, I am aware that if you cool down from a place where the vein is close to the surface, like putting cold water on your wrist, it does cool down the body.
Okay.
Well, the wrist doesn't have the best vein. So there's my buddy coming up to me as I am sweating. I am warm. I am outside in the immediate. He goes, you're doing it all wrong. You got to take an ice cold bottle and you just kind of get it in there and then you clench, and you'll feel great. You'll be like, that is the dumbest thing I have ever. I love you. So now I'm walking like a penguin, but I'm very comfortable.
Well, that's because you're a bottom.
That's why penguins walk like that. They're actually overheating.
They're very warm. Well, they're penguins. They're supposed to be in the cold.
A cold bottle between your legs.
A cold bottle between your legs. Totally worked. And I don't mean totally like works. 5 minutes later I felt better. I am talking about within a minute I was able to get back in front of this camera. It works. And everyone at home who's about to try that, you're welcome.
Mm-hmm. I'm so glad I don't have trouble with being cold. Like, yeah, exactly. I'm always warm.
You're in three layers. You have a hoodie and a robe over. Well, it's a sweatshirt, but still, I'm saying.
It's good. It's nice out. What is it, like 80?
And these lights.
What, is it 80 degrees? I don't know.
You need to understand, Zanny does not mind wearing a robe wherever. Remember the weed walks we talked about earlier? Wandering around the city? I go, yes, it is time for a journey, and I put on shoes. I put on pants. I put on a shirt.
Oh, my God, for the pants.
There goes Zanny. He's like, you know what I want? Robe. Oh, is it slightly chilly out? You know, 70 degrees. Second robe. Oh, my God, 60? Third robe. We own jackets!
Yo, you gotta bring five
They're
robes.
They're not as elegant.
It's true.
Well, except for the burned one.
You can't go wrong with a robe.
You know the rapper Two Chains? They're the rapper Three Robes.
Three robes. I was three hoods deep. Do you know how many robes deep was I once?
Four.
Three robes.
Four hoods deep.
Four hoods deep.
I was once four hoods deep. I had four hoods on my head. It's like it was a hoodie and about, I believe, a few robes, right? Four hoods deep.
How does everyone else beat the heat?
Have you ever heard of a swamp cooler?
Think I'm Thanks about to, and I don't
you're
think
stealing
I want
mine,
to.
But yeah.
Is it German?
You take a 5 gallon bucket, you put ice and water in it. All right, you take like one of the doorknob drill bits, you drill holes towards the top of the bucket, you put a little bit of PVC pipe there, right? You put the lid on the bucket, you cut a hole in the bucket that the desk fan will sit on top of. Plug in a desk fan, put it on the top, blows air in, hits the cold water, pushes it out the PVC pipe. Evaporative air conditioner called a swamp cooler.
Boozy.
Swamp cooler.
I am so happy right now.
Boozy, it feels like you're explaining to me how to construct a refrigerator. No, the way you build a swamp cooler is you walk your ass into your favorite store that sells like a hardware store, and you buy whatever model of swamp cooler you want because you live in Phoenix, which is where some houses are swamp cooled, motherfucker.
Look, Boozy wants to be MacGyver. Let him be MacGyver.
Look, okay. This is $85.
You know how much my shit costs? It costs a 5 gallon bucket and a bag of ice.
Yeah, and the ability to know what the fuck you're doing building a swamp cooler.
That's what the internet is for.
You cannot drill a hole in a bucket.
My shit will automatically.
Shit, it's you. Never mind. Go to Home Depot. Buy one.
If you spend a little bit of money, you can get one that will automatically temperature control, and you play it out the back of your garage like God intended.
Like God intended.
If you leave this person with a power drill, their home will look like Swiss cheese. You can't do that.
He'll be sitting there drilling into the ground for crickets.
Alkali's like, God made air conditioning for a reason.
Do you know how many of his rooms are painted screen green?
Treats. The amount of things...
Yes, the what is it? What
green,
is it?
Chroma key green. All right, so we all know what the Dragget Show has. The Dragget Show has a chroma key green bong. Who else has chroma key green stuff in their house? We're all... Nothing yet? Oh, start painting
you
stuff.
You have an entire
Just
wall.
Just the wall that I keep my liquor on.
Fair enough.
Yo, can we tell you that Moore got a whole... Oh my God, it's green, man. Full-on Zentai suit that's chroma green.
Nice. So we'll never know if he's in the stream with you. Is that what you're saying?
He could. Yo, if they decided that was the time, they could. They're like a true ninja. Oh, whoa. Fighter of the Deja. Oh, whoa.
I just want to see a figure pass in front of you like the Predator.
You just watch a bag of donuts going across. Like, who's that? Oh, go with God. That's more.
That'd be wonderful. Holy crap.
That's Moore's donuts.
Donuts floating around.
I had to do a stage presentation once, and anyone who's ever worked with the stage or anything like that, everyone has an understudy. Everyone. So in case you're not there, somebody can take over.
You see them?
Well, in this case, our lighting director, and the understudy. Both of them gone. So we're doing this stage presentation, and all of a sudden we realize that all the people in the background who are supposed to be the haunted items, all of them wearing total, like, black Zentai suit, black hood, just so they can fade into the background with a small lit piece of prop that they're going to be moving to be the haunted scene.
Yeah.
The spotlight director didn't know. So the entire scene had a spotlight on the main character, a spotlight on the anti-hero, and a spotlight all over the place in the back with all these people in full blackout gear just like...
God damn it, Mitch, get the fuck around!
Perfect performance.
Wow.
It was brutal. It was absolutely brutal.
Yo, I would have been having the best time of my life if I was the actor in the Sentai just moving shit. My favorite thing, okay, this is a little bit mean because I'm around, this isn't even mean. My favorite thing is to be a minor bit player in a train wreck where I'm not blamed for the train wreck, but I'm kind of part of it. I love that shit. All expectations crumble around me. And as long as I develop at least a C performance, oh, I have hit the rafters, baby. Because there are fuck-ups deeper than I could possibly imagine. I love that. Who else? Holla if you know what I'm talking about.
Quizzy, you help out at a stage production, so you've had to see some gorgeous moments.
I don't help out at a stage production.
What's your most pleasant
I am on the board of directors for a community theater. Oh my god.
You make decisions, don't you?
My favorite one is there was a 5-month period where every meeting opened with, okay, and the first order of new business this month, there's still a hole in the building.
Dragons must have been there.
Happy Pride.
There's the hole. There they go.
Happy Pride.
Aw, so cute.
So, did you fix the hole, or did you end up using it in a show?
As of, from what I understand last week, and like, I'm not talking like it was a little hole. I mean, like, a chimney fell down, and there was a large hole in the building. For 5 months. It's like, I would come home from meetings, QM would be like, how was the meeting? And I go, it was okay. And then they go, is the hole still in the building? And I go, yeah, the hole's still there. As of the last meeting, the hole has been patched.
With what?
Well done. All well right. done. You did your job.
With what?
That's a good question.
I don't know.
So ask questions you don't want the answers to.
Somebody happened to crash and it's duct tape.
All right, Pep. Just for you, and then we do have to go to the
shout-outs.
I was cast mainly because they felt bad for me. I was supposed to have a totally different role, and they loved my voice because we had done it, but they didn't actually see me. And they're like, oh, 6'8", kind of 100. You do not look the part at all. We're sorry we can't give you that. I get you. No problem. Like, hey, you know what you could do? Do you want to play this like weird villain kind of guy? Like, yeah. That'd be wonderful. So they get me all set up. I'm the evil wizard. It's great. I have a big old beard. I have a wig, a long white hair. And all I have to do is one scene is stand there. 1-minute monologue. Squib goes off in front of me. Big pillar of smoke. I need to know not to buckle my knees. Trapdoor opens and I fall into a mat underneath the stage. The stage is only this tall. I have no problem with this. I know I need to hit. I need to roll. I need to fall. We're good. Night of the second performance. The first night went flawlessly. Second night, Squib goes off. Big bloom of smoke. I buckle my knees. Nothing happens. No trapdoor whatsoever. The smoke clears and I just go, ha ha! In the middle of my laugh, the trapdoor opens. My knees are already locked, but I only have like 3 feet to fall. So now I'm this tall on the stage. And I go, ha 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 ha! Slowly, oh my god.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it was probably my favorite performance.
You were so short.
I was so short.
You're so wee.
I was so short.
Now you know how we feel. Anyway. Anyway, we got shout outs.
I'm going to need everyone's help for this. This is called shout outs. Right. Shout outs. Shout outs. I wonder who is next. We're just going to do the last line of it because we've only got five minutes.
Yeah, so those who give us Patreon stuff, we get to do shout outs. We randomly select them. Here are three of them.
Here's how this one's going to work. We are going to go down the line. We each get to do one sentence of a story. Pepper, for this one, you will be ending the story. QM, you start it. We need a story for... Tezcat Magic Jag. Tezcat Magic Jag, QM, start a story one sentence at a time.
All right. Tezcat was watching a movie.
And then the Fire Nation attacked.
Xander, don't think. Go, go, go.
Oh, my God. I don't even know what that means. Go ahead.
And it didn't matter that he didn't know what it means because dinner was obviously done. Smoke alarm blaring. Fire Nation attacking. There was only one thing that could help him.
Chickens. That's right, chickens.
And that's how they got their GED and really turned their life around.
Nicely done.
Jesus.
Boozy, you're starting this one. QM, finishing it. Our next one, thank you so much for your patronage. Our story is about Foxhole. Foxhole. What happened to Foxhole?
The first thing you need to understand is that the majority of a coyote's diet is actually crickets.
It's not as bad as you think, but it's actually really high in protein.
But it didn't matter because this particular coyote was shunned from his group for continuously using the pun, "Dinner is going to bug me."
Holy shit.
Shit! Ah!
But it didn't matter because that coyote had decided the first time he was going to pee was at his bat mitzvah.
Finish it off.
And then at the bat mitzvah, he had cake made with crickets.
Aww.
And he enjoyed it.
Aww.
Happy ending. Cricket cake.
I like that I said first time they're going to pee as if they've never peed. Like, it's been 15 years. Like, here it comes. I'm going to release this.
I also like at the bar mitzvah, he became a verman.
All right.
Our I'll final shout out. This one starts with Xander and ends with Boozy. Final shout out goes to Kahari Worgen. Kahari Worgen, thank you so much for your patronage. Xander, what happened to Kahari Worgen?
Zanny? Kahari Worgen was out on the fields of the Warcraft because that's where Worgens are from.
They were on the fields of Warcraft, which was strange because it's a video game, so surrounding him were empty boxes strewn as far as his eye could see, and each of them cost $9.99 a month.
And then the dinosaurs came, but they all died and turned into oil.
So being oil, they decided to fuel the Decepticons. Taking their trucks up and down American highways until the end of history.
Well, and those cars eventually evolved to become the cars in the movie Cars.
Did you know the cars in the movie Cars are actually homunculus? Just like this patron.
Hey!
Ladies and gentlemen, both and neither, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We are the Dragget Show. I want to give a huge shout out to all the people who came out here this weekend. But before we do that, to all of you, we cannot for 2 days. I just got to spend time with my friends, people I consider family, some of the closest people to me, and I have not seen any of them in about 9 months. Conventions will be back soon. A coworker of mine once asked me why I do conventions so often. Why do you always go? And I said, because I truly like being on stage. And he said to me, well, shouldn't you do it less? Absence makes the heart grow fonder. And I kind of laughed at that, and I immediately went to a convention and told him he had to work on a Saturday, which was funny to me. But I finally understand that one. After 9 months without any of you, these last 2 days have reminded me what we've been missing. It has been an absolute pleasure to perform with all of you. And to everyone out there, in a few short months, conventions are coming back. I cannot wait to see you. I cannot wait to have a drink with you. And more importantly, I cannot wait to see what you bring to that stage. Conventions will be back. Please keep your eye online. Keep your eye on the conventions. We're going to need support. Charities are going to need support. But again, we're the furry fandom. We are like the Brazier of the world. We offer support. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank all of our people. Let's give a huge round of applause to QM! Woo! On this side, thank you for joining us, the ever-smoking Pepper Coyote!
Woo! Jesus Christ.
You
fucking idiot.
You never know about his law. Ladies and gentlemen, the Boozy Badger.
Woo! Homunculus.
The Homunculus Badger. Guest of honor for 3 years in a row. Let's give it up for Sue the Deer. Oh, Sue. Woo! The only person I know to ever be terrified by a member of her species out in the wilderness. Awesome.
Yes.
And of course, the creator of the Dragget Show, my wonderful mate. Let's give it up for Zanny. Zanny the Blue, thank you so much for making this all happen.
Let's give it up for Alkali Bismuth. Woo! Woo!
Yeah. If there's a camera that can do it, I need a shot of everyone behind these cameras to AV for making this happen. They have literally worked for 12 hours plus today. None of this happens without your dedication and your ability to recreate a damn generator from scratch. Well done.
Like a swamp cooler.
There was a generator, then there was not a generator, there was a different generator, and we're here, baby.
This has been Anthrocon Live. We hope you're enjoying yourself. Enjoy the rest of the event, and good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Anthrocon Line. Fine, change. You changed the name 3 times today.
Things change.
Love you, too.